So here am I, and I'm just thinking about something that just came to my mind as I've been analyzing a lot of talented individuals, a lot of well-gifted people around me and the people that I know. Some of them are my friends, and I'm one of the people that I've also been studying. So I'm asking myself this question. Why is it that even though they are talented and they are gifted, but it seems as if it's taking ages for them to rise up and for the world to know them? Then something came to me to say, a lot of times we've been taught that in order for you to become great, you need to know what you're good at. You need to discover your gift and you need to discover your talent. But what has happened is, once we discover our gifts and our talents, it seems as if we are not breaking out still. And I've been asking myself the question, why is it Messi is one of the greatest soccer players that ever lived? Is it because in our dispensation he's the only one who plays soccer that good? If I am to be honest, even though I'm a Messi fan, if I'm to be honest, is Messi is not the greatest soccer player alive. And before you press that button, those who love Messi, please listen to what I'm saying. Messi is the greatest soccer player alive that we know of. Exactly my point. So what we need to know is that, in as much as you are good and you have a great talent or you have a great gift, that alone is not enough. It's not enough. There is a scripture that I read, and as I read it, like I said, I no longer read the Bible just from a spiritual point of view, but I read it from a practical point of view. As I read this scripture in Matthew 5 verse 15, it says, no one lights up a lamp and put it under a basket, but instead they put it on a lampstand so that all in the house may see. This scripture is not just touching a spiritual principle, but it's touching a practical principle. The reason why that soccer player who may play soccer greater than Messi is not known, it's not because his talent is not great enough, but it's because his talent is under a basket where no one can see it. A lot of times we only stop at discovering our gift and working it, but we don't put much effort in putting our gifts on lampstands. The difference that was there between David and Goliath is, every battle that David fought, that battle was under a basket. In other words, there was no audience. There was no one who could see David killing a lion. There was no one who could see David killing a bear. Whereas with Goliath, every battle that he fought, there was an audience. That's why there was a testimony that was given to David when he wanted to fight Goliath. The brother said, you are just a youth. This man has been fighting battles from since he was a youth. So in other words, David's battles as a youth, no one is there to see them. Goliath's battles from a youth, there is an audience. So what you need to do is, you need to begin to find a way to put your gift or your talent on a lampstand where there is an audience. That's why we have been given tools that can assist us in this day and age. There is YouTube, a lot of social media platforms. Whatever you are doing, you need to make sure that it is recorded. Because when it is recorded, that is your lampstand. That is what you are going to use as a platform to display your gift and your talent to the world. So please, whatever gift that you have, whatever talent you have, it is time that you put it on a lampstand so that it can be seen by all. I hope this will help you. Now rise up, go out there and become legendary.